The Life of Jacob Black. Jacob Black is a shapeshifter or werewolf of the Quileute tribe, former beta of the Uley pack and alpha of his own. In Twilight, he is 15 years old, and in New Moon, he phases into a wolf for the first time at the age of 16. In Breaking Dawn, he imprints on the hybrid baby named Renesmee Cullen, the daughter of Edward Cullen and Bella Swan. Welcome to the Amagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Jacob Black. Before we begin, we publish new content every week, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Early life.
We used to make mud pies when we were little.
Jacob Black was born to Billy and Sarah Black. Throughout childhood and adolescence, Jacob's two best friends were Embry Call and Quileute the Fifth. All three attended school on the Lapush Reservation. During childhood, he and his sisters, Rachel and Rebecca, were sometimes acquainted with Charlie Swan's daughter, Bella, though they never became real friends and Bella remained mostly in California and Phoenix. When he was 9 years old, his mother Sarah died in a tragic car crash, although he recovered from the pain better than his sisters did, thanks in part to his sisters, Rachel and Rebecca, filling in the role of mother for him as much as they were able. Rebecca married a man named Solomon Fanoe and moved to Hawaii, while Rachel moved away to attend Washington State University as soon as she finished high school. Since her sisters were away, he became his father's only company at home, especially after he became wheelchair-bound due to diabetes. However, he did not resent taking care of his dad. In fact, he enjoyed his father's company, though he refused to believe in his family legends and traditions. When the Cullens first moved to Forks, Jacob did not understand his father's aversion. After a while, he began tuning out most of what his father said. Twilight. Jacob has a small but very important role in Twilight. Jacob is a longtime close family friend of Bella due to both of their fathers, Billy and Charlie, being best friends. He meets Bella for the first time after she moved back to Forks when she and some of her schoolmates spent a day on First Beach, where Jacob and his friends first encountered them. After Bella flirts with him as a way to extract information from him about the Cullens, he introduces the idea of Edward and his family being vampires by telling her the Quileute legends on the topic. Bella feels guilty for using him this way, but finds him easy to talk to and very friendly. After Bella and Edward began dating, Billy takes Jacob to Bella to advise her against it, without, however, telling her why. She already knows. He is later seen crashing Forks High's prom under his father's orders to reiterate the same warning. In the movie adaptation, Jacob first shows up to bring Bella her new truck and give her tips on how to drive it. However, in the beach scene, he doesn't actually tell her what Edward is. In turn, she's forced to do her own digging to get the answers she wants. He later comes to Bella's house with his dad to watch baseball with Charlie. New Moon. Months after Edward and his family leave Forks in New Moon, Bella becomes very close to Jacob, who comforts her during her hardship by trying to cheer her up by engaging in various different activities, including motorbike riding. Jacob helps her to become somewhat happy and normal again, though she still deeply misses Edward. New Moon reveals that Jacob is one of an ancient line of Quileute werewolves. They are the mortal enemies of all vampires, including the Cullen family. At first, Jacob thinks this is all a bunch of superstition, and he becomes frightened and disturbed by the influence a young man on the reservation, Sam Uley, has on some of the Quileute youth, especially after his best friend, Embry Call, joined them and cut contact with his other friends. After Jacob went through an unexpected transformation into a werewolf, it is revealed that Sam, the pack's leader, was the first to make the transformation in several generations. He'd gone through his own hardships during the change, including a rather bloody incident with his fiancée, Emily Young. As werewolves are short-tempered, highly violent, and likely to explode into wolf form when angered, Jacob is initially forbade by Sam to see Bella in order to protect her from him. 1 week later, she visits him at his home and tells her off, saying that he now knows about the Cullens being vampires. He and his new friends patrol the forest, searching for vampires that have been killing hikers in the area. Jacob and the pack save Bella from the vampire Laura, who is trying to kill her. Before the oversized wolves chase him off, Laura tells Bella that Victoria wants revenge on Edward for killing her mate, James, by killing his and make him experience the same pain that she felt. Sometime later, Jacob unexpectedly shows up at Bella's bedroom window and apologizes for their recent fight and his avoidance of her. When she asks him what is happening with him, he claims he can't tell her, but leaves her a clue to what he and the rest of Sam's group is. Bella remembers the stories Jacob told her on First Beach about the Quileutes being descended from wolves. The next day, she confirms that Jacob is a werewolf. She later confronts him, assuming his pack is behind the recent murders in the forest. Jacob convinces her that their job is to protect humans from vampires. They would never intentionally harm anyone. He also tells her that Laura is dead, and together they figure out that a certain red-headed vampire terrorizing the werewolves and hikers in the forest is actually Victoria. But when Jacob calls his pack to give them the news, they are angered about it. Paul, one of the pack members, loses his temper, phases into his wolf form, and tries to attack her. Jacob quickly phases in turn and mauls Paul, chasing him into the woods. Afterwards, Jacob and his pack assign themselves to protecting Forks, Bella and Charlie from Victoria while hunting her. She and Charlie spend a vast majority of their time in La Push during spring break. Jacob and Bella renew their friendship, and he tells her what it's like to be a werewolf. Sometime later, still in grief over losing Edward, she tries to contact him by engaging in a daredevil activity and goes cliff diving. She nearly drowns before Jacob is able to pull her out of the water. Upon returning to the Black's home, Bella and Jacob learn that Charlie and Billy's friend Harry Clearwater has died of a heart attack. A quick succession of events later that evening and the next day pry Bella and Jacob apart. Jacob drives Bella home, only to discover that Alice has inexplicably turned up there. He recoils from her presence and flees to La Push to regroup. He returns to the Swans' home the next day to apologize to Bella. They nearly kiss when the phone interrupts them. When Jacob answers, he mistakes Edward's voice for Carlyle's and, refusing to surrender much information, tells the caller that Chief Swan was attending a funeral. Having received cryptic information, Edward assumes the funeral is for Bella, thinking she had committed suicide. Grief-stricken, he departs in order to meet with the Volturi, and Bella and Alice rush to try to stop him. Jacob is deeply hurt and disgusted by Bella's choice, Edward's return, and Bella's willingness to go back to him and become a vampire, but reluctantly agrees to protect her father in case Victoria shows up. However, their job ended when the Cullens moved back to town. In the epilogue of New Moon, sometime after the Cullens returned, Jacob turns in Bella's motorcycle to make Charlie ground her in an attempt to prevent her from seeing Edward, though he doesn't know that she's already grounded for leaving without explanation. He also reminds Edward of the Quileute Cullen Treaty, which forbids the Cullen family from biting any humans. This means that if a member of the Cullen family turned Bella into a vampire, the treaty would be broken and the werewolves would start a war with them. Jacob is upset by the whole conversation, though Bella manages to calm him down before he can try to attack Edward and before she and Edward leave. However, when Bella turns to look at Jacob one last time, she sees that he is suffering in heart-wrenching emotional pain and that he is heartbroken. Eclipse. Eclipse begins with Jacob still trying to keep a safe distance from Bella, who desperately tries to communicate with him. He's not comfortable with the idea of Bella associating herself with a vampire, making him almost lose control with anger and hatred. The book starts with Bella receiving and reading the note from Jacob. He has a hard time expressing himself in it, as she reads through many unfinished sentences that end up being crossed out. The last comment in the note is not crossed out, and shows that even though he misses spending time with her, he is still angry about their situation. Later on, however, his affection for Bella grows even stronger. He's enraged that she will become a vampire after graduation, which is only a few weeks away. Horrified by the news, he makes it his goal to save Bella's human life no matter what. Bella feels bad that she's spending all her time with Edward and sneaks off to visit Jacob. He invites her to a Quileute council meeting and she accepts. They spend the night together and listen to tribe legends believed to be real by the Quileute. When Edward realizes that he has been too overprotective, he encourages Bella to visit him on a regular basis. On one of the later visits, Jacob tells Bella that he loves her and kisses her, thinking that she loves him back and is reciprocating his affections. Bella, outraged by this, punches him in the jaw and breaks her hand. Jacob brings Bella home and Edward threatens him that if he ever kisses Bella or forces against her will without her consent again, he'll break his jaw for her. But Edward also claims that he would allow it to happen if she wanted to kiss him. A while later, at a graduation party held at the Cullens' house that Jacob decides to attend, he gives her a charm bracelet with a carving of a wolf on it as a graduation present. While there, he learns that Victoria has amassed a newborn vampire army to attack Bella. Jacob and the pack eagerly agrees on joining forces with the Cullens and learning how to fight these newborn vampires who are significantly stronger than the Cullens. Their original plan was to have Seth Clearwater watch over Bella in a remote mountain place while the Cullens and the rest of the werewolf pack fought off the vampires. Bella, however, wanted Edward with her. Edward agreed as long as Jacob would carry her to the place in the mountains so that her scent would be disguised by his stench. They followed through with the plan, and Jacob carried Bella to the mountain hideaway. While waiting for the battle to be over, Edward, Bella, and Jacob set up camp. A blizzard blows through the camp, and Bella begins to freeze. Jacob comes into the tent and stays in Bella's sleeping bag to warm her up with his abnormal body heat, much to Edward's chagrin. During the night, Jacob asks Edward about his relationship with Bella and what it felt like to lose her. They bond and temporarily set aside their hatred for each other. In the morning, Bella wakes up and Jacob leaves the tent. Bella and Edward then start discussing their marriage plans. Jacob overhears their conversation and runs away upset. Upon Bella's request, Edward brings him back and leaves them alone to talk. As they talk, Jacob tells Bella that he's going to kill himself because she doesn't love him. Bella begs him not to do so and offers to kiss him if he promises to come back, and Jacob agrees. At first, Bella is hesitant and starts to resist, but she soon finds herself kissing him back passionately and realizes that she is in love with Jacob after all. Jacob then leaves to battle, promising that he will try and not get himself killed, but gets injured trying to save Leah Clearwater from a newborn vampire. The newborn mangled all the bones on the right side of Jacob before being destroyed by Sam. Carlisle patches him up, and a worried Bella visits him later. Jacob is shocked to hear that Edward didn't get angry at Bella for kissing him. They talk, and she tells him that, although she loves and cares about Jacob deeply, she has still chosen Edward. While heartbroken over her choice and deeply hurt that he couldn't save her despite his best efforts, Jacob doesn't show it and reluctantly agrees to stop trying to separate them. Jacob reminds Bella that he will always be there for her whenever she needs him. The epilogue is written from Jacob's point of view. Jacob and Leah are sitting at the edge of a cliff, with Jacob thinking about how difficult it will be when Bella is turned into a vampire, which to him isn't much different from dying. Leah tells him to get over her, and Jacob angrily tells Leah to leave him alone. At home, he finds that Edward has sent him an invitation to the wedding. Enclosed there is a note saying that he is not obliged to attend, but that if Edward was in Jacob's shoes, he would want a choice. Edward thanks Jacob for everything. Unable to endure his human emotions any longer, he phases into a wolf and runs away. Jacob runs as fast as his legs can carry him. The rest of the wolves try to talk to him, but Sam tells them to leave Jacob alone. Breaking Dawn. In Breaking Dawn, Jacob is mentioned to have been gone for almost 2 months now, and is trying to live the rest of his life as a wolf so he doesn't have to deal with the pain he is in. Jacob is first seen at Bella's wedding, having decided to attend despite his pain. He apologizes to Bella and tells her that he only wants her to be happy. However, he becomes violent towards Edward when he finds out about their plans to make love while Bella is still human, and has to be restrained by Seth and Sam. During Bella and Edward's honeymoon, Jacob, rage-filled, imagines the different outcomes of the honeymoon. Jacob is the narrator in Book 2 of Breaking Dawn. When Bella returns from the honeymoon, Jacob believes that she has been turned and demands the pack attack the Cullens. Sam refuses to do so, and Jacob goes on a solo mission, leaving his own home in the process. He finds out that she is pregnant and sees that she is bruised where her child is kicked. He talks with Edward, who doesn't want the baby because it is killing Bella, but can't do anything because Rosalie Hale guards Bella upon Bella's request. Rosalie's choice influences Emmett, Esme, and Carlisle, and so Edward cannot force Bella to have an abortion. Desperate, Edward asks Jacob to offer Bella to get pregnant with him, resulting in a much healthier pregnancy than the current one. Jacob is sickened but tempted, and agrees to try to persuade Bella to abort. He also promises Edward that he'll kill him if Bella dies. Jacob informs Sam and the pack of Bella's pregnancy. The pack plans on killing Bella and the baby because they see the unborn baby as a threat, which is however protected by the Cullens. Jacob still loves Bella and rebels against Sam's authority as Alpha. He embraces his Alpha heritage and breaks away from the pack. Seth and Leah Clearwater join him patrolling the Cullens' territory and preventing Sam's pack from attacking. While running patrols, Leah requests to stay in Jacob's pack after Renesmee's birth. Though taken back by the idea, Jacob agrees to think about it. Leah admits to Jacob that she understands Rosalie and Bella, and that, if their positions were switched around, they would do the same for each other. Jacob is enraged by this and is led into an awkward conversation about Leah being menopausal and her love for Sam. Jacob ends the conversation to check up on Bella. A few days later, Edward hears the baby's mind for the first time, and he loves the unborn baby as it already loves Bella, leaving Jacob feeling betrayed and mad. Edward hears this and gives the keys of his Aston Martin Vanquish to Jacob, so that Jacob might get away from them. Jacob desperately drives out to look for his soulmate, someone who he may imprint on so that he would forget his love for Bella. His search ends up fruitless. Jacob comes back and learns that the baby is not trying to hurt Bella anymore. Edward asks Jacob, as heir to the chief, Ephraim Black, for permission to change her into a vampire after the birth of the child. Feeling empty inside, Jacob agrees. When Bella goes into horrifically painful labor, Jacob kicks out Rosalie, who'd lost her control, and performs CPR on Bella while Edward delivers the baby, who is a girl, and Bella names her Renesmee. Seconds after that, Bella's heart stops and Edward bites her to turn her into a vampire. Jacob feels completely empty by her death and intends to kill Renesmee for revenge, but instead imprints on her when he sees her. This also cures him of his heartbreak over Bella rejecting him. He nicknames her Nessie because her real name is a mouthful, and this irritates Bella since it refers to the Loch Ness Monster and catches on. Jacob is extremely close to Renesmee, goes hunting with her, and for Christmas he braids her a bracelet that is the Quileute version of a promise ring. Jacob has a strong desire to protect her and keep her happy and safe. It is likely that his feelings will eventually turn into romantic and sexual interests when she is older. It is hard for him to be separated from her, so he visits every day and almost never leaves the Cullen house. However, he states that once Renesmee's growing slows down, he will go back to school. Finally, Sam's pack stops trying to attack the Cullens, since the most important to the werewolf laws is that one cannot kill the object of another wolf's imprinting, due to the damage it would cause to the wolf in question. It is also stated that Jacob's close friends, Quill and Embry, who stayed with Sam when Jacob went his separate way, have also joined Jacob's pack after Renesmee's birth. When Irina comes to Forks and mistakes Renesmee for an immortal child, she reports to the Volturi. Knowing they may need help to stand against the Volturi and that Renesmee is in the center of the danger, Jacob reluctantly tolerates the Cullens' vampire friends during their stay, all of whom have agreed to witness for the Cullens. He also sends his troops to run with Sam's pack for the time being. On Christmas Day, he gives Renesmee a hand-knitted bracelet, which is his tribe's version of a promise ring, as a present. Days before the Volturi arrive, Bella plans for Jacob to run away with Renesmee to Rio de Janeiro, so that they may be saved from the upcoming slaughter. She has passports forged for the two of them, with Jacob as Jacob Wolf and Renesmee as Vanessa Wolf. Jacob shares a tearful goodbye with Bella and Edward when their confrontation with the Volturi coven is about to turn violent. However, the situation is drastically neutralized when Alice and Jasper bring another vampire hybrid named Nahuel to prove to the Volturi that Renesmee isn't an immortal child nor a threat to the vampire world. After the Volturi shamefully left, Bella is overjoyed and calls Renesmee Nessie for the first time. In the movie, Alice has a vision of the upcoming battle. In it, Jacob is escaping through the forest with Renesmee while being chased by Santiago, a powerful guard of the Volturi. His running slows a tad when he hears Seth's death in Leah's mind, and the guard nearly jumps down on them when he snaps out of it and kills the guard to make their escape. After the confrontation ended peacefully, with the only casualty being Irina, Alice has a vision of Jacob and Renesmee in the future. They are in love and living happily with their families. Edward tells him he is glad that Renesmee will have him in the future, but is still not ready to grip the idea of being his future father-in-law. At the end of Breaking Dawn, he, along with other wolves, hears from Edward and Arrow that they are not really werewolves, but are rather shapeshifters who can turn into wolves, correcting the mistaken belief that had been accepted in their tribe. After the Volturi's trial, Jacob jokes that life will be boring now, which Edward remarks that he fervently hopes so. Unbeknownst to him, Bella and Edward suspect that he will have to compete for Renesmee's affection with Nahuel, but they decide to postpone their worries until the time comes. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.